Albania, a country in southeastern Europe, is not a big country. The Kruger National Park in South Africa would be two-thirds the size of Albania. The distance from east to west is 150 kilometers, and from the north to south, 340 kilometers. Albania shares land borders with Montenegro to the northwest, Kosovo to the northeast, North Macedonia to the east, and Greece to the south. Leaving Tirana, the capital city, I quickly learned that Albania is not flat and has a number of mountain ranges running in different directions. Following World War II, the country became initially a satellite state of the Soviet Union. In 1967, hundreds of mosques were destroyed, churches were converted into cultural centers for young people, and preaching religion carried a 3 to 10 year prison sentence. Albania was declared the world's first atheist state. During the Cold War era, over 750,000 concrete bunkers were built. I've no idea who would have wanted to invade Albania. After 40 years of communism in isolation, an uprising, most notably by students, led to the first multi-party elections in 1991 and the fall of communism. From the rural farmlands, I followed one of the valley roads to Gjirokastër, otherwise known as the Stone City. Gjirokastër Castle is one of the biggest in the Balkans and goes back to the 14th century. A fortress that dominates the town and overlooks the important route along the river valley. From here, I headed southwards towards Greece, stopping en route at the Blue Eye, a natural spring in one of the valleys.
Good morning, how are you?
Girocastra. Souvenir, siamo in Albania, castello del Girocastra. Souvenir di Albania.
Close to the border with Greece, I turned north and followed the coastal road, staying overnight at a few of the smaller resort villages. This coastal road is by no means flat, with some serious mountain passes. Along this route, there's a submarine bunker built during the Cold War. The underwater base is massive, 650 meters long and 12 meters high, and could accommodate four Soviet-built Whiskey-class submarines with torpedo and rocket arsenals. Turning inland again and headed towards Berat, a small town with white Ottoman houses, known as the Town of a Thousand Windows. On a hilltop, Berat Castle is a huge compound still inhabited by townspeople. From here, I headed back to the coast again before heading north to Skauder, the town on the border of Montenegro. Then from here, I looped back again towards Tirana, the capital city, ending an enjoyable 1,200 km cycle tour around Albania.